And we continue to ask the experts all day long with a mission in mind to keep you informed, up to date, and really finding the finest in the industry in Central Florida. When you look at our lineup of experts, those are the people you can trust. And they do become household names, and these people certainly are. This is the BCN Law Firm show called Law 2020. Law 2020. Your friends at the BCN Law Firm at 352-394-2103 or 855-LAW-2020. I finally sat down last week and transcribed that. It's 855-529-2020. Took me the longest time to figure that out. Gee, well. Anyway, it's bcnlawfirm.com. Wade Boyette is here with a very special guest that we've had on before. Wade, the floor is yours.
We are here with Hilgard Lamprecht. He's a really good friend of mine. He's a financial planner here in Orlando, and he threw an amazing client appreciation party last night, and I, you know, figured after a couple of glasses of wine, I could ask him to come and be the guest here. So I cornered him last night at about 11 o'clock, and he agreed to come in on the show and, you know, help us out here this morning.
Well, I tell you what, it's so important. You know, I was saying recently to a bunch of people up where I live, where you have an office in the Villages, and I was saying, you know, you went all your life. You got your college degree, and then you got the job, and then you had the kids, you got the house, and all you look forward to is when the merry-go-round ends, when you retire, and then you can just go down to the shore and cast out the bait and get a beer and sit back, and you have no worries. But then all of a sudden, right about the time you're 55, Hilgard, you start realizing, what is the required minimum distribution? What the heck is my IRA? What is a 401k? Why do I have to do this and have to do that? Volumes upon volumes, a library of books could be done things we do not know about retirement. It's a pretty scary road out there without somebody to help us.
Absolutely, Rob. You remind me of a good friend and a client that recently came into our office, and she's a retiring teacher, and she's been putting monies aside, setting some monies aside, all different kinds of accounts. And she said it the best I've ever heard anybody say it. She said, Hilgard, I really don't watch it. I don't know what I have. I just know that in about 3 months from now, I'm going to retire. And now it matters a lot. And one of the things we always try to encourage our clients, especially at 50, 55, is to really start paying attention. You are growing your wealth. You're moving towards a spot financially where you're going to really look at those accounts to produce an income stream for you. And the typical scenario is when you stop looking at your car keys in the morning and you start looking at your investment portfolio to produce that check in the mail, it makes all the difference. And so starting to look at that earlier in life, 45, 50, will make a tremendous difference as to how much money and capital there will be, and therefore how much income there will be and how much financial security and flexibility you will have during your retirement years, so that when you do cast that bait in the lake or you tee off at one of the wonderful golf courses, you have peace of mind.
I tell you what really bothers me, and give me your opinion on this, and you too, Wade, is the baby boom generation probably the worst generation in a long time as far as planning? I mean, a lot of people are waking up right now at 60 and saying, I really don't have any savings. I just have a house and a car that I make payments on. Wow. Is that pretty much the scenario with most people these days?
It comes down to urgency. You know, Wade will probably contest to this. A lot of times, if a legal event happens, people really pay attention to their legal documents or their contracts or their wills or their trusts. The same thing happens with planning. It's not something we wake up in the mornings with and said we need to go do. But the peace of mind you have when you really have very, very good advisors that deals with that and monitors what you have and maximizes what you have makes a world of difference. And you can go back to your normal life and know that you're on track. Wade did my estate planning documents for me. And the best way for me to describe it to you, Rob, is, and literally every time I get on an airplane, and I'm flying myself now recently, and so every time I get in an airplane, I have peace of mind because I know my legal plans have been established, my trust, my wills, everything is done. Anything would happen to me, I know my family is going to be in a good spot. And that peace of mind is priceless.
Mm-hmm. And, you know, if, sitting back and just putting your head in the sand, we've learned from a lot of the shows we do here and a lot of the phone calls at 855-297-9696. Text us at 21232. An awful lot of what goes on is people just say, well, Social Security is going to help me, and I've got that 401k. I don't know how much is in it, but I think that's going to help get me through. And then all of a sudden, I guess they wake up to the reality one day that they go, whoops, I've still got payments going out, but every 1st and the 15th, my bank account's not growing by $5,000 or $10,000.
Yep.
You know, what's happening here?
You know what I see too, Robin, you're talking about the baby boomers, and it's a little bit, Hilgard and I were talking last night a little bit about planning for millennials. You know, the baby boomers, that generation loved debt. And unfortunately, they still have a lot of debt, a lot of them. And, you know, it's not necessarily how much money you make or how much money you make get receive every year. If your expenses exceed your income, it doesn't really matter. And, you know, the millennials, I know, you know, a lot of the younger kids that I come in, I say kids to me now, 20s and 30s that I do their planning for, you know, they don't like debt. You know, it's a totally different generation.
Smart.
So I think they've gotten smart from the debt standpoint. And, you know, what I see in planning now is, how do you shed that debt? You know, how do you get rid of the debt?
Where do you start, Hilgard? Where do you start when a couple comes in and sits down with you and says, I don't know, we got a shoebox full of receipts here, and yeah, we know we get our taxes done every year, but now we need to start planning. And when should they start planning? At 30, 35, 40?
Rob, great question. Really good question. You start with a plan. You start with a plan. At our firm, Life Wealth Group, our mission in life, if you would, is to help people maximize their life wealth. And it all starts really with a plan. So we start with their goals. We start with what it is that they want to accomplish in their life. I break it down into things they want to get done today, areas that I call our wish list, which is 2 to 5 year goals, and then longer term goals. Typically, people would love to have their children have a great education and a retirement. And then also the protection of wealth is very, very important. And that's how I work with Wade to help our clients really protect their wealth. But, you know, the best time to start is today. Absolutely, it's today. Compound interest is absolutely your friend. You probably have heard people describe the rule of 72, which describes basically 72 divided by an average rate of return. Let's just say 8% gives you the amount of years for your money to be able to double. The answer of 72 divided by 8, that's the amount of years it would take your money to double. So compounding is your friend. The earlier you start, the better. But what's extremely important today is that the average rate of return conversation has changed. The game has changed. The markets is significantly more volatile than it used to be, as well as that what influence the markets today are different factors than back in the 1960s, where the buy and hold strategy was developed and said that you just need to put money aside and do a good job in spreading your money and you're going to be okay. The world has changed in that regard in a big way. So to be able to generate an average rate of return, you really have to watch how those monies are managed on an active basis.
Yeah, and I think that people don't do enough research, and that's where you guys come in at your firm, because a lot of people are sitting there with money in CDs at 1%. And just saying, well, it couldn't be any better anywhere else. Well, there's a lot of places where it can do a lot better than 1%, which are pretty doggone safe, you know. So they need somebody like you to help them through. How do people get a hold of you? The name of your company and the contact information again?
We are the Life Wealth Group, and our phone number is 407-299-4129. Again, that is the Life Wealth Group. You can see us on the internet at www.lifewealthgroup.com. And our phone number is 407-299-4129.
And we're going to take a break when we come back. One of the things I'm going to ask Wade is, why is it important for a family to have their legal ducks in a row and the legal part of their group communicating with their finance people? Get them all on the same page. We'll talk about the importance of that. Things you really need to get done, folks. I know it's not as fun as football or picnics. But you're going to need that money someday. We'll be back. 855-297-9696. You could get on the News 96.5 app or text us at 21232. We'll be back. Is the master of bumper music, I swear. 1222, he's our producer, and you're listening to News 96.5. This is the Ask the Experts program, and we do have Law 2020 on right now. I love these guys. Law 2020, BCN Law Firm, offices Winter Park, Claremont, Lakeland, and now offices on Highway 466 in the Villages. And we're so proud to have them. During the week, 352-394-2103, 352-394-2103, or you could just call them at 855-LAW-2020, 855-LAW-529-2020. Now, you can call the show right now at 855-297-9696. And, Wade, why is it important that a family have the legal team, the legal documents in place, have a nice relationship like you've got with your clients because you're friends? You socialize together, you see each other at Publix, at the football games and everything, and have a financial planner that's all working together and know each other.
You know, and add into that mix a good CPA.
Oh, yeah, there you go.
Sure. And that makes up your team. And, you know, they're all interrelated. If I do a great job with my documents, and I, you know, the client comes in and we plan well for the, you know, the legal side of things, and I don't communicate with Hilgard or the financial planner, I could really undo or mess things up tremendously. For example, mm-hmm. I may have a client that says, you know, I have a handicapped child and I need everything to stay in trust for that handicapped child. I don't want to disqualify him for certain social benefits they're getting. And I do the plan. I create a special needs trust. Everything is great from my standpoint. And I fail to talk and work with Hilgard and the beneficiary under Hilgard's life insurance, retirement accounts now may just be the son or be the estate. And now instead of it going to the trust like it should, it'll end up going to the child and end up disqualifying them for social benefits. I mean, there's so many ways. That's one example. But it is very important for us to be on the same page.
Mm-hmm. Hilgard, you mentioned during the break that now is the time that people should be planning on next April 15th. And aren't we just a little bit late on that? Because, you know, you've had adjustments on your pay all year, and now you're in the last month of the year.
Well, Rob, good question. Essentially, we got basically a month and a half right before December 31st to do what we can do to reduce our tax liabilities for next year. And if you're going to do something, now's the time to do it. This is truly tax season, or tax planning season. Wade and I work closely with our clients. Wade's got some strong tax planning degrees and knowledge and experience, and so we work with our clients to try to minimize the tax bills. You know, it's kind of like a credit card. You get the credit card statement at the end of the month. You see what's going on. You might feel an ouch, and there's nothing you can do about it. It's the same way with your income tax. You're going to finally get that income tax return done. You know, after, there's nothing you can do about it. Now's the time, folks. Now's the time to do something about it. I will just tell you, in short, the tax code has changed. Mm-hmm. The government has become more stealth in the way that they are taxing us by taking away a lot of previous deductions and phasing deductions out. And it's time for us to become stealth. And it is very important to be speaking to your financial planner, your tax attorney, and your CPA during this season.
There's an awful lot of people that have no idea about just the hidden taxes in the Affordable Care Act.
Correct.
There are tons of them.
Correct.
And they come up at they'll start showing up this year when you go see your tax man, and you're going to be, well, what do you mean I sold a house last year and I might have more extra liability?
That is correct. That is correct. The typical, you know, medical expense deduction you could take on an itemized deduction used to be 7.5% of your adjusted gross income. Anything above that, that's raising up to anything above 10% of your adjusted gross income. And that 2.5% just reduces deductions. And there are many more like that where itemized deductions that we used to be able to use are just not being able to be used anymore. Mm-hmm. And it's just time to become aware and be proactive and go do something about it, unless you want to write a big check next year again.
Let me ask you this very basic question, and that is, there are people arguably listening to today's program, and they're in their 20s, 30s, maybe even their 40s. And they say, well, we don't have a lot. Why do we need financial planners? We're not millionaires like some of these people in town. We don't live in Alworth and Aliqua. We just live here in a nice 3-2. Our kids go to school. And, you know, why is it so important that they get somebody helping them with their finances now?
It's a great question. It's the same question as, why don't I just go write out my own will or use LegalZoom? Why would I use a professional, you know, like Wade and his lawyers? We all go to college, and we have a lot of years of experience. If you can have somebody in your corner that truly wants to maximize what you're doing and knows ways to be able to do that, either by the reduction of a tax or a better way of managing your wealth and positioning your wealth, it makes a very, very, very large difference. I would say, Rob, you're kind of hitting the nail on the head. Most folks think that to have a financial advisor is going to cost them a very, very large amounts of monies. It typically is not true. If somebody could work with you and maximize what you're doing with your wealth, the multiple or the benefit that you receive is far in the 3, 4, 5, 6% range, or 3, 4, 5 times what you've done before. So to me, it is not an expense. It is a really good investment in yourself, mm-hmm. and in how to maximize what you'll have at the end of the day.
And doesn't it come down to, we spoke during the break, doesn't it come down to if somebody says, well, I don't have a whole lot of money and I'm going to get a good Social Security, but let's get into that little can of worms for a minute. They just think 62, 66, 70. They think it's that simple.
Yes.
No, it's not quite that simple, is it?
No, it's not.
They can take advantage of a lot of good things. Why don't you expand on that?
Yes, it's a great decision. It's many people at that point in time have paid into Social Security for quite some time. And, Rob, it doesn't matter the level of wealth. I think everybody or know everybody wants to maximize what they are giving from their Social Security check. A lot of decisions, a lot of thoughts to go into when to start your Social Security. There's a taxation of your Social Security. There's a reduction of your Social Security. And then a big thought is for married couples is how they are planning for each other based upon what monies would be available if one of those folks were to pass away.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of factors. We do some studies for our clients, and we help decipher them all the different decisions they can make to make a great decision.
You have found that you can probably sometimes give them over the years of their retirement an extra $40,000, $50,000, $60,000, right? All doing it legally.
Well, my regulars won't like me to say that, and I cannot say that, but I will say that we have many, many, many very happy clients who we've been able to help over the years to maximize what they have.
All right, very good. That's financial planning through the Life Wealth Group. And you got the BCN Law Firm. Together, they work really cool for you. We'll take a break for news, traffic, and weather. When we come back, let's open up those phone lines at 855-297-9696. You got questions about where your money is, where it could be working harder for you? We've got some ideas. We'll be back. You can join the conversation today at 855-297-9696. You can use the texting feature on your smartphone by just opening it up, and where it says recipient, put the numbers 21232, and then in the body, just ask a question. You don't have to use your real name. When you call in today, you don't have to use your real name. But if you say, well, we've got $10,000 in CDs, and we have another $40,000 sitting here, here, and here. Give us that scenario, and let Hilgard kind of walk you through it and see where if you're settling for that 1% right now, you probably got some problems here. And if you have questions about, of course, allocations from your 401k, what an IRA can and can't do. We recently had a caller, Hilgard, from somebody who said that their financial planner, who I guess just wasn't up on the news, had told them, don't cash in your IRA to buy that piece of property you want to buy. You can't do that. And so, one of the guys on this station said, own the property through your through your IRA.
Correct.
And the guy said, well, my financial guy said that's impossible. So they need help from you, right?
Well, it's good to have a straight answer. It's good to be able to know what you can do and cannot do. You know, just had a question from one of our CPA partners on Friday asking what a person can do with a beneficiary IRA if they could take a beneficiary IRA and transfer it to a Roth. Very interesting question. It was a non-spouse beneficiary, and the answer to that was no, unfortunately not. But more and more people are seeing or starting to look at the tax code and understanding that their qualified plan, their 401k, their IRA are pregnant with an income tax. And to start investigating either creating tax-free sources of income in the future to protect themselves more, or whether it makes sense to convert an IRA to a Roth IRA. Mm. Those are very good questions. They're very good, wealth maximization issues to consider. And we do a lot of that planning.
Very good. Okay. Wade, let's go back to something we breached just a little bit in the first show, or the first half of the show, and that was how your two firms work together. Let's go to there for a minute.
Well, usually what happens, we both are on the planning side. You know, Hilgard will sit down and he'll work from a financial plan side. I'll look at it from an estate plan perspective. And then we have to work together and make sure both of those mesh. You know, we'll usually sit down, Hilgard will sit down and really do a great job of understanding what the client's needs and their desires are from a cash flow standpoint, you know, what their debt looks like. I'll sit down and have that heart-to-heart, you know, if they were to pass away or become incapacitated, where do they want their assets to go? How do we protect that wealth? So Hilgard will work with accumulating wealth, generating wealth, and then I'll sit there and protect the wealth.
Have you seen some people who have really, really not prepared at all for this and thought they were?
I shouldn't say most of the clients, but a lot of clients that come into our office, you know, they went and met with an attorney years ago. You know, a lot of them had a financial planner, and they saw the financial planner 8 or 10 years ago. Or what I see more often than not, whatever their employer provides from a 401k standpoint, whoever that person is, that just comes in and says, here's our allocation this year. And that's the extent of their financial planning. It's, you know, I know the 401k has 6 choices and they choose one of the choices and that's all the financial planning they're doing.
Do you find, I heard this on a national show the other day and it really, really intrigued me that we've got some listeners out there who have some very deep pockets, some very deep buckets. They've got a lot of money. Do you find sometimes, Hilgard, that maybe a CEO of a company or head of a large group of any kind is probably the last one to admit they need help in financial planning?
Yes, I do, and I don't blame them, Rob, because these poor fellows, they are, you know, a lot of our clients are CPAs actually that are chief financial officer at companies, and they look at spreadsheets every day, they look at their organization's cash flow every day, and they just get tired at the end of the day, and they don't want to look at it for them. Their personal lives. So we take the role of becoming the personal CFO for those families. And I just understand they people are tired at the end of the day and they don't take the focus. Mm-hmm. But the way that I would describe it to them is that if you can imagine you having the energy and the focus that you are using every day in your organization, if you can apply that to your personal financial world, what will the difference be?
Well, and the angle, that's a great way to look at it. Another angle that they were talking about on the national show was some of these guys just think they know it all, and they're not going to have somebody else telling them that, well, you know, you'd be doing better if you had some money here or some money in that.
Correct. 91% of investment success has everything to do with where your money is at what point in time. And as Wade alluded, most people spend maybe 5 minutes thinking about that. But life moves fast. The markets move fast. We have a very, very intricate world economy that influences where money grows and how money grows fast. And so it's impeccably important to focus or know if 91% of your success has everything to do with where your money is at what point in time, is to have a team involved in helping you mm-hmm. maximize your money and manage it proactively.
Would you agree with the premise that basically in the U.S. economy, if you look at the scale over the past 100 years, that about every 5 or 6 years, we face a correction. And then we go back to square one, a base. Let's say the market's down at 5 or 6,000, and then it starts climbing again. Well, the other day we were flirting with 17,000. And a lot of people are saying we are stretching that bubble well beyond the sixth year of recovery. When is it going to burst? And the text is, what is your personal opinion as to the direction of the stock market in the next 6 months of the year? So reach down there where that bowling bag you're carrying, get out that crystal ball you've got, and tell us what you see.
You know, my crystal ball, after I really, really shook it up and was shining it up, I think the genie came out to give me an answer here. It's very difficult, obviously, over 6 months to a one-year period of time, but surprisingly, our investment management team is seeing more good news today than bad news. Most folks have looked at 2014 and said, you know, such a great year in 2013, we have to have a negative year. We don't see a negative year. We see a strong end for the year. We don't see major downturns. We see still that we are in a bull market, and it probably will continue for the next 4 to 5 years. So,
Do you feel that it's because we learned something from the last bust that was so severe that a lot of people now are putting some money away, paying down their debts? And the statistic was out last week. Fewer homeowners than in years are behind in their bills. Credit card bills, automobile payments are down to like 1% to 2% in the 90-day category.
I think they've been listening to wait a lot because the general public has reduced their debt, very, very well. Absolutely, Rob, I agree. Statistics are saying that average family debt is down, employment is up, average amount of cash a family has is up. I would say that, yes, as a nation, we have learned and apply those lessons very, very well. I wish our government can do the same, but nevertheless, people have made good decisions, and I think they're much better prepared than they were before.
Mm-hmm. And watch the ripple effect. When you don't have that debt, your stress level goes down.
Yeah,
you have all those million of people who aren't stressing, then healthcare expenses go down. I mean, there's a lot of...
I never thought of that.
Yeah, the ripple effect of just people getting out of debt and getting that stress off their back.
Mm-hmm. And I guess when you're growing at the pace this economy is growing, but we're growing smarter than we got through the economy that built in the 80s was an economy of greed. I have to have that $200 shirt. I have to have that BMW. I have to have that certain watch make. Mm-hmm. You know, I have to travel to Vail every year. And now people are being a little bit more conservative. Would you side with that, Wade?
Absolutely. I mean, and that, again, going back to the millennials, I'm just impressed that, you know, they did learn from some of the older generation's mistakes. And it's not a me generation quite as much and a materialistic generation.
Well, and the other thing, though, Hilgard, that this comes back to, and I'm sure a lot of our listeners are seeing themselves in our discussion of the past 10 minutes, and that is the people that haven't planned that whatever wealth they had going into the last recession is now gone. And they're sitting there at 50 or 55 saying, how in the world can I rebuild enough so that I can ever retire?
Yeah, it is a great point, Rob. The issue we see today, it comes down to make a dollar and keep a dollar. In wealth management today, what is very, very important is to continue to protect your downside. Grow money and protect downside. Grow money and protect downside. You know, ultimately, people are looking at what is the number that I need to have in order to be able to have an income stream. But that's a big, big differentiator in what I see in today's environment as a result of what happened in 2008. The second thing I see, especially folks who are in the retirement phase of life, coming back to you to your question and point you made about most people, very, very large group of people have money sitting at 1% or less in interest accounts.
Gosh.
And we have to do something different today. Our interest rate environment is low. It stayed low. People have to do something different than they were used to do. They used to be able to go to the bank and just put it in a money market account and get a 4% or 5% return or CDs. Those kinds of returns are still out there today. You just have to go do something different and go see a financial planner and let them show you some options. The better kind of options are options where the principal is very actively managed to provide downside protection help and provide a bigger income stream.
Mm-hmm.
One of the biggest misses, if you would, for me in life with retirees is the fact that they are not maximizing their income. People are living on a day-by-day basis where they could have more income if they would just enter into planning than what they have. And so it's just sad for me to see that these folks have saved their whole life. They have an amount of principal, but they're not maximizing their income.
I was looking today, and I was looking at the at a website which shows several money market offerings right now that are pretty liquid, and they're pretty substantial companies, but that are protecting you 8.2, 7.5, you know. But nobody's talking about that. I don't know why those people aren't advertising like crazy, those funds. But anyway, they're out there, and you can find them. Hey, but you need some guys to help you along the way, because if you make a lot of it but you don't have any planning for it, you could lose it just as easily. We're going to take a break. Three big things you need to know, followed by your questions at 855-297-9696. We'll be back. All right, welcome back. It's time for us to bundle all that information we've been talking about. That was a phenomenal, fun discussion of finances. I love that last segment. All right, 855-297-9696, text 21232. Okay, Hilgard, you got a husband and wife listening to this in the car, and they're going, all right, maybe we want to call Hilgard next week at Life Wealth Group. First of all, give us the number, and then tell us what they need to bring with them. A lot of people don't have a financial planner because they don't know what they need to bring.
Great question, Rob. Our phone number is 407-299-4129. And what I would say is I would invite. We have a second opinion service that we offer to our clients and prospective clients and families that are interested in the discussion. We would analyze what they're doing and what their portfolios are looking like and probably spend 3 to 4 hours in our time to be able to see whether or not we can help and whether or not we are a good fit for a husband and wife couple who are interested in interviewing with advisors. Many of our folks take advantage of our second opinion service. I can tell you the quality of work we put into it is high quality. And if we cannot help or we're not a good fit, we can point a family into the right direction with another advisor that could be a better fit for them.
All right, very good. And, of course, then you tell them what legal documents that you think that they are going to be needing and that sort of thing, and that's where Mr. Boyette comes in, right?
Correct. 90% of the times when we meet a new family, their estate planning is not going to do what they have set out to do. It's just not going to happen for reasons that Wade already have explained. Folks have not taken the time to draft the documents. Many folks have not reviewed the documents. Their life has changed substantially, and then their documents is not coordinated with the beneficiary designations or the titles, in their accounts. And very important to coordinate those factors in order for the plan to happen.
Mm-hmm. How often should somebody be sitting down with their financial planning company?
At least once a year. And depending upon the level of complexity, maybe even quarterly or semi-annually.
Mm-hmm.
But for the families that we work with, we ask that we at least visit once a year. And then we have ongoing communication to our clients on a weekly basis as far as what's happening in the markets and quarterly updates that we are sending out to our clients to keep them informed and explain that we very actively monitor the accounts and the wealth that we put in place for them.
Mm-hmm. Do you find sometimes that you have to be not only a financial planner, and I know Wade has this in his firm too, but you have to be a psychologist and sometimes a shoulder to cry on? Because I'm sure when there's market fluctuations at 3 o'clock in the afternoon, when the market's down 3 to 4%, I imagine your phone's starting to ring saying, what are we doing? What are we doing? Where's my money?
Yes, it's a good question, Rob. to have anybody in your corner, to have an advisor in your corner that you trust and is of great value, to a family is priceless. Many times I've gone and picked up the phone and said, wait, I have a circumstance or a situation, and what do you think? It gives me a tremendous peace of mind, and it helps me, and it's great to know that there's people that are really in your corner. We aspire to be that for the families that we work with. Just a second opinion, if you would, or just a phone call and to say, you know, I got this set of circumstance. How would you think through that? Because we're very proactive in the way we communicate, as far as the markets is concerned, many of our clients are not that concerned.
All right, very good. As a way of wrapping it up, you can get to the BCN Law Firm this week at 352-394-2103, or 855-LAW-2020, 855-529-2020. The Boyette, Cummins, and Nalos firm has a lot of associates that specialize in various things, and they can help you in Winter Park, Claremont, Lakeland, and a brand-new office in the Villages on Highway 466. And Hilgard, let's get your information one more time.
You can reach us at 407-299-4129 or on the web at www.lifewealthgroup.com.
All right, very good. So we're going to wrap it up, and we've got more experts coming all afternoon long. So you can watch the football, keep the sound down, and listen to the radio, and you'll be much better off for it. Thank you, and we'll see you a little bit later this afternoon.